This is the second in my Real Weird World series. I had something else in mind, but the first installment was a science one and it wasn't so successful. So I'm contemplating a different scientific series that I can upload once in a while, just because I like doing the science ones. I can be a little egotistic at times, can't I? So let's keep this series a bit creepy and strange and controversial, maybe. And let's today talk about a strange tale of time travel. It was on the 2nd of November in 2000 on an obscure internet discussion board that a man calling himself John Titor or Titor posted the following message. Greetings. I am a time traveler from the year 2036. I am on my way home after getting an IBM 5100 computer system from the year 1975. My time machine is a stationary mass temporal displacement unit manufactured by General Electric. The unit is powered by two top spin dual positive singularities that produce a standard offset Tipler Susinoid. I will be happy to post pictures of the unit. According to some sources, he did not use his name John Titor until January 2001. Subsequently, a lot of questions were asked and people found out he was military and he made some predictions on the year 2004 and beyond, some vague, others specific. He said he was from Tampa, Florida, from the year 2036, as we already said, and part of a governmental time travel project. He was sent back to the year 1975 to retrieve an IBM 5100 unit that runs the APL and basic programming languages. It was necessary to debug various legacy computer programs, possibly referring to the Unix year 2038 problem. He was specifically chosen for this mission because of one of his paternal grandfather's direct involvement with the assembly of the computer, and he was on a stopover in the year 2000 for personal reasons. He often described his time machine saying it contained two magnetic housing units for the dual micro singularities, an electron injection manifold to alter mass and gravity of the micro singularities, cooling and X-ray venting systems, gravity sensors, or a variable gravity lock, four main cesium clocks, and three main computer units. He had been trying to warn people for the Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, better known as mad cow's disease, and for civil war in the US. He confessed an interest in UFOs, a mystery still unsolved in his time, which made him think they were from the future, in a superior time machine, or with superior time machines. He said the many worlds theory was proven, but that the differences between this timeline and his one would be minor. It would also exclude the danger of the grandfather paradox, as he would be killing the grandfather of a different John Titor. He made several predictions, like the US Civil War that would start in 2004 with civil unrest surrounding the election year. It would then erupt in 2008 and it would end in 2015 with a brief but very intense World War III. He also said CERN would discover the basis for time travel in 2001 and there would be no Olympics after 2004. You would think that the hubbub would end when none of these predictions actually came true, but he had written himself a way out by saying that him being here would create a different timeline from his one, and the longer he stayed, the greater the differences. After that, John Titor seemingly disappeared. A report from John Huxton, who runs the Hoax Hunter website, named Larry Haber, a Florida entertainment lawyer, and John Rick Haber, his computer scientist brother, as the man behind John Titor. People who still believe in John Titor contribute his apparent disappearance to him returning to his time/timeline. But there is another theory out there, as there are people who believe the former time traveler John Titor is none other than current US President Donald Trump. Conspiracy theorists believe he is using the highest position on the planet to avert the impending nuclear war. Oh, this was really interesting, but of course I want to know what you think. Drop a line in the comment box with your opinion, but please be respectful. Remember that there are real people with real feelings at the other end. If you enjoyed this vid, you can always like, share and subscribe if you haven't already and want to see more. And I have another channel you might want to check out. And from my corner of this weird world to yours, I hope to see you next time. Bye!